that shape. And then they enlarged the mastaba, as you can see. They make it, and instead of square, it became a rectangular shape. And they add four steps, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They add four steps, and they make it small pyramid, as you can see. And then they add that layer, so it became the final shape. Mm-hmm. You see. The height is 62 meters, and from that side, from east to west, it is 125.27 meters. And from north to south, smaller because it's rectangular, it is 109 meters. Mm-hmm. Okay. The fascinating thing is that the series of tunnels underneath, and the tunnels like I made, Mashi? Okay. So those tunnels, I made it in a separate picture. Mm-hmm. That is the entrance from the north. And you can see it goes to a main shaft. And look how many tunnels, how many. And those are not the only series of tunnels here, but also the whole area. Here are series of tunnels. And here are series of tunnels, and here and there. So the whole area is surrounded by tunnels. Mm-hmm. This is one of the pictures found in the one of the rooms here. Okay. And this is another picture from the from that side, as Neter Khet Orvet, the divine body. But later in the Middle Kingdom, they referred to this name as Djoser. So the man himself didn't say, I am Djoser. Mm-hmm. But later records mentioned him as Djoser. So we keep saying this, Djoser. You see, that is another way to say how they can change labels. You have a name, but later some people will call you another name, and the later people will keep calling you that new name.
Sure.
Don't follow the original name.
You realize the city?
Oh, it's the same, yeah.
Yes.
Because I
so far,
we're
sorry. Symbolism in the doors. Made from stone.
Has a real mm-hmm. door, but made from stone.
Yes. So
you can see. As if it is closing.
Mm-hmm.
This is another part, like a folding, folded door. You know, that door can, it doesn't actually really open, but you can make it like two folds. Mm-hmm. Just something like this.
Mm-hmm.
So it was magically maybe palm trees or packages of papyrus, mm-hmm. reeds. The same like the ceiling, as Yusuf explained yesterday. That the early people used to live in like huts with palm logs above. So this is, could be something similar.
Yeah.
If we follow that basic information or translation or explanation. But in another way, it could be very, how do you call it, important in sound, vibrations.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
But I also heard once that, like, from my father, that there is an influence of a different civilization in this structure because it's all represented in the style of wood. And since wood was not so available here, so they made it from stone, but they made it to in the shape of wood from the same background. If we went up the gate here, we would be able to see a very, very nice view.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Okay.
Mind your step, huh? This is the Pyramid of Djoser. We can see the carving, or like the pit, mm-hmm. that shows how deep the structure is still going. This is the complex that we believe it was a sound healing hospital. The only remaining three chapels, but at every entrance you see on both sides, there used to be like one. So there was more than actually 22, I think. The platform here on the left side, is also what my father labeled as an investigation table. And he said that there was a connection between the niches and between it, wireless connection, of course, by sound. And that the physicians would stand inside the niches that we're gonna go and see, and they can cite what's wrong with the patients who will be standing, or who will be having the choice to step on the table from the left side or from the right side. And the basic idea of sound healing, that it's when we have a healthy body, we have a frequency. Mm-hmm. And we have an ill body, we have another frequency. So it's the way is to sit the body on the right frequency or on the health frequency back again. Mm-hmm. So it's a vibration that will be coming from outside in to tune you back in with the vibration that you're supposed to be in if you're healthy.
You know, it's as if we have a kind of machine, but something wrong happened, or any kind of like cell phone, and then suddenly it became Japanese language and you don't know. So you switch it off and then on, and then you bring one with English language, this is the right one, and you keep follow the same steps, then you reach the right choice and then you make it. This is like this, someone sick and someone not sick with a very good health. So as if he is sending the right formula to his body to repeat doing this, to fix this amount, this blood will be like 10%, the oxygen, they do things inside the body. So as if they are sending such instructions to the sick man, for the sick person. مش هنحميها تسيب المطر ينزل على بعيد
طبعا
هو عمل لها مظله حمايه
بالظبط كده
لان انت شفت فين حاجه حمايه
عملت ايه انت طيب يعني انت لما جاي تعيب عليه عملت انت ايه
بالظبط
انت ما بتعملش حاجه طبعا كان بيكامينج فروم ذا انشنت ايجيبشن فريز سا مير را which means the beloved birth of the light or the beloved birth of ra وايد خلصت
لازم تكمل تيجي في الشغل كان حد بيسأل فيك
لا
ولا كان صح ولا مش صح نفس
This definitely has a different look it's than anywhere else. You notice it right away.
Exactly. It's not megalithic.
No.
But not all the activations need megalithic.
Right.
But there is the ancient structure with the megalithic stone. You can see the same combination.
That is restoration. Mm-hmm. Or it was made a cover to protect the place by a French Egyptologist. But this is the original shape. That is the height of the pillar, and that is the only part remaining from the real ceiling.
Oh.
So the whole ceiling was made like with this acoustic design. Uh-huh.
ما تقعد
ده على ايه مور وايت كلاسايت which is the whole floor here was cased with white calcite over there there's also pieces of quartzite and basalt stone which is when we go to a site like that even if it was transformed several times if we found the combination of stones that we are used to see in a pyramid structure which is the combination of quartzite rose granite white calcite basalt stone and this combination of stones then we realize that the site is very ancient even if it's Greek or Roman or Islamic or whatever the last layer is if we find the combination of stones we know that this was a power plant that was transformed. The stones were quarried again and again until it took the form. Same like the renovation that we are doing today that required bringing more stones and workers and everything to do the renovation.
You see what they did?
Yeah.
Remember the map I show you?
Mm-hmm.
And all the details I show you were clear before they made that wall.
Mm-hmm.
That will hide all the details of how it was small mustal and then getting bigger and then the layers.
Mm-hmm.
That will hide all those details.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what they are doing, hiding evidences. Like this place, but as we say, we are lucky that they cannot hide 100%. Like they tried to dismantle all of it. That is all with alabaster flow. But they left some, so we understand that it was like this.
Mm-hmm.
How we know? Not because we found only this, but because in other places we understand that the whole floor was alabaster.
Mm-hmm.
So that is wasn't a part of a pillar or big wall. And I don't know if you realize this, when we are talking about anything, we care very much about the final layer.
Mm-hmm.
Pyramids, buildings, or even the granite we saw in the Serapeum. You know what is going to happen if we erase the layer of that granite? And in the future, when you have the chance to go to Alexandria, you're going to see the stone is deteriorating as like harder than limestone.
Mm-hmm.
If we erase the layer, the skin, if we can call it skin, the skin of granite, it deteriorates harder than limestone.
Mm-hmm.
So when the final layer, or the outside layer of the building was removed, so as if the place became naked, and all the conditions, the weather conditions and the locals, okay, and rain and storms or winds, found that it is easy to change the shape of the building, because its skin mm-hmm. disappeared. Like our body, imagine if someone lost the skin, what's gonna happen? All the viruses and bacteria is gonna attack him. East side. And in each shrine inside, the priest is gonna go and tune maybe, or sending thoughts, positive energy to those patients who mm-hmm. are staying or laying on those beds,
mm-hmm.
dog beds. Would you like to go and try?
Yeah, that'd be real cool. So I'm now in what would probably be the priest room. And then that table, which the one in front of me is smashed, would be where my patient was. Can't seem to get it to tone. That's probably too open now.
That the king and the queen will be sitting here on their throne, mm-hmm. and that the Egyptian people will be here. Like this court is going to take the Egyptian people. Why not in the bigger court at least?
Right.
And other stories about like that's where they used to repair the bull tail, or like the king will pretend that he's fighting the bull there, and then he will hide here. They cut the tail, and he will come out with the tail as the victorious. Sometimes they just like they have these ridiculous stories that they just got so used to repeat and repeat again and again. And they have shafts here, most of them they cover with slabs of concrete.
Mm-hmm.
So we're gonna see one here. So we know that there are shafts running underneath us here. We're gonna see several ones on the site of the Pyramid of Winnings.
Mm-hmm.
Until today they're digging. There is whole chapels from white calcite crystal. So don't think that the core of this pyramid is something like eroded, like the outside renovation like that. No, there are megalithic pieces that's also reflecting high-tech machining.
Oh wow.
فتحوها يعني؟
لا يعني كان في باب هنا.
لا كم بنظم بتاع خشب هنا شادو
يا حبيبي بركة. This all was taken from underneath the pyramid of Djoser, and it, the whole pile is white calcite crystal. This is all white calcite crystal. From some of the cuts, we see the surface, and we see the patterns of advanced machining.
Oh wow!
And the tube drilling machine. The finest type of white calcite crystal, and it's in the core of the pyramid. So if this is the radioactive core, then it will be inside the pyramid. The camera doesn't want to work?
No, it does. It just, I always turn it on and off real quick, just by accident. Yeah, you can clearly see the circular. Smooth as all hell.
Hundreds of years of sandstorms, and we have sandstorms every spring. That's why I don't like spring in Egypt. It's the worst season.
Right.
And then when it rains, this kind of mud with sand, it turns to a kind of concrete, natural concrete. So this is what you can see above there. But basically nothing in between.
I mean, 60 feet?
At least.
Give or take?
Yeah.
I mean, this is several tons of material to bring out. And that's solid bedrock, right?
Yeah.
So that's very difficult to...
That's a chamber. The rock here is in a tube drill that leads further. So there is further depth and the linking it to the other tunnels.
Yeah.
All so, these concrete.
So the actual room is not in the bottom.
No.
It's deep and there is a horizontal tunnel.
You see this concrete pieces?
Mm-hmm.
They're all covering shafts.
Yeah.
Here, back here too. So the whole thing here was, remember when we talked about the structure front of the Great Pyramid? There used to be the same temple here. This is part of the crowns of the pillars. We have the quartzite, granite, and a huge deposit of white calcite is in the ground. Can you see? All this is white calcite crystal.
The floor is here.
Yes. But even when we look over there, we will find that the channels of water running in the white calcite, but it was cased with a layer of limestone, so it was not revealed. So why hide the beautiful looking stone with limestone? Because it was not about beauty.
Right.
Look at this piece of work here. That's an amazing piece.
See, it's perfect. Straight with the temple and with the gates.
Nothing was done by accident. Everything is purposely placed.
By accident, it's impossible to see.
Just imagine the work needed to lower this and make the angle in the single piece and like that one. They most solid, more than even quartzite. Look at the cuts. It cuts through flint easily. If I'm using a hammer and a chisel here, I will smash it. It will be smashed. But this is a cut through, clean cut.
You know, in modern times, when I have a drill to hang like a picture or something big one, and I use a drill to make a hole, in concrete, if the drill will hit the flint, I must change the location because the drill will not go through the flint. Or I need a kind of very expensive drill to do this.
So imagine
this is cutting the flint.
Mm-hmm.
Look at here, when in the broken area, Look at the amount of flints with some calcite and quartz in it. So this is a very challenging. If the quartzite here, the normal one, is 7 or 7.5 in the Mohs scale, mm-hmm. but with the flint content in it and pieces of calcite like this, these are even more challenges for the tool. But believe me, if this flint is here and I am coming with a hammer and a chisel, it's not gonna cut the surface like that. Now it's gonna be smashed. Mm-hmm. Unless the tool is very sharp and very solid. Beautiful type also, quartzite. You find the same type in Tawanaku.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly the same, mm-hmm. and the pink quartzite. The pieces of limestone with the stars on them, they were part of the ceiling. Usually, there would be a court, where the building would contain around 16 pillars, and then in the center, there would be something like an, what they call the open court. But nobody mentions that underneath it, there is a whole structure.
Mm-hmm.
Only rain. So what causes, and if it is rain, it means it comes from above.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing above. It's only there.
Right, why is there a giant crack there when mm-hmm. it should be everywhere?
Look at pieces like this. That's the same piece.
Mm-hmm.
It's the same one. Yes, this is limestone, but it's still so challenging. It's reflecting the powerful machining. I will show you something here that is really a couple of things. We didn't see, we heard, but we didn't see Ramses or any of his sons renovating. They were always quarrying.
Like the one we saw yesterday in Giza Palace.
Mm-hmm.
He said I was quarrying. But why they said restoring?
These writings up here. Well, these are beautiful writings.
Mm-hmm.
What does it say? Usir ma'at ra'a, seti ben ra'a. That's the title of Ramses.
The one in the right side in the top, mm-hmm. number two.
Mm-hmm.
We call the pyramid Unas, but I understand if we didn't find the name Unas inside the pyramid
we
or anywhere else, we will relate this to Ramses II.
But because they found, these are writings from the new kingdom.
So we found older.
We found writings inside, or like archaeologists found writings inside that's relating to the fifth dynasty. So they relate the pyramid to the fifth dynasty.
Because
what if it was
old.
Added like mm-hmm. this one?
Yeah.
What if it was added later like this one? How can we tell the difference?
Mm-hmm.
Massar, add his name. Ilmu, add his name. I can add my name if you give me my time on a chisel. I love this pyramid. The fine casing of that limestone, which is not local to the area, but also the core of it, is not rubble. It's constructed in a very
good quality.
In a good way and in a good quality stone. The thing with these stones, I'm going to show you some examples here that really. Like for example, you look at this surface and you look at this angle and it's going straight. That's normal, but that's not the whole case. There are some pieces here that interlock in a very like complicated way. Like this case.
Oh yeah, the angle.
It's going this way.
Yeah.
It's not going straight like this.
Yeah.
It's coming that way, and it's going that way. That means this one is also aligned with it.
The same, yeah.
So this. For both to lock together in a good way like this one, that's after, of course, pieces from it is broken. But that means any mistake in the angles, both going this way, will separate the two stones
yeah.
from each other. Talking about
the opposite in the other side. Opposite.
This one also. Yeah. rabbit. Mm-hmm. It is entering in deeply, mm-hmm. like this. So that's another challenge that I see, that there is no need for them to do it like this one. They could have just made them straight and stick them beside each other.
Right.
But these cuts like that.
This is hard.
Very challenging. Really,
it's a, if any mistake with the angle, they will have a gap like this. Mm-hmm. Just
at any point.
1 degree different. They're gonna have
a, I mean, just the physical planning alone.
I want to tell you that beyond here, more to the south, there is an entire section reused by the new kingdom. So we are here in the old kingdom. There is an entire section here in the south from the new kingdom time. So, and further, also to the south, there is a Coptic monastery, or what's remaining of it. Sites were inherited again and again.
Absolutely.
Everybody benefits from it the way they can. Saku, 1930. But how can we know that these older writings is as old as the structure? There is no way to know. The only thing is, they say that this is the first pyramid that contained the pyramid text. But what about all the other ones that doesn't have it? Just because they were built before the 5th dynasty? The Valley Temple of the Bent Pyramid had lots of glyphs.
I'm going to put it on the table. Dollars.
Ladies and gentlemen, they have the officials has the key.
That's crazy.
Did I tell you that the temperature inside pyramids is the same all year round? And that the temperature, especially in the king chamber, in the Great Pyramid, is exactly like the human being temperature.
Wow. 98.6? Well, Fahrenheit.
Abu Hakim. Jeddi. And this sandub اللي فيها alabaster?
والله
ما فاكر. انا فاكر انه كان حال زي كده.
انا اخر مره دخلته كان حوالي 20 سنه. كان مفتوح هنا في الكليه.
So this heavy erosion here, it's really strange because it definitely looks like water erosion. But what's strange is you could, if it was coming from one side, you could buy it, but there's all four sides of this pyramid have the same erosion, which is just really strange.
Hit me in the face.
about to be a shitting hieroglyphic on the wall. A bat to what is your thoughts on the purpose of this?
Perhaps for the limestone aquifer. Mm-hmm. It would help if it would contain the water. Mm-hmm.
Has Chris Dunn been here? what do they call it? There's a name for bat poop, but there's something in it that they can get. It's like fertilizer or something. Here, Down here at night? Yeah, that's what I...
They lost the fear all the time.
Good for them.